Hey guys, so in this video I wanted to show how to put together one of my newer prints, which is the GEN2 XL sheet holder for your steel sheets that you get with your print. Look how massive this thing is. This is the one that comes with the XL. I've been having this sit on tabletops, collecting dust, and I know there's a lot of prints out there for like sliding in sideways, but I really wanted to make one that is more out of the way. Like, I've made these in the past for the Prusa, you know, the Mark 3s, Mark 4s, Carbon X1, and then I came up with an adjustable one for the Prusa Mini. So I'm like, man, I should really make an adjustable one for larger printers, such as the XL and the Vorons. So this is the large one. So I'll show you how it goes together. So with the GEN2 adjustable steel sheet holder XL parts all printed, we want to grab this piece. This is the right side of the holder, and there is an adjustable slot on there that we need to clean out. For this, I'd use an X-Acto knife, or in this case, like a utility knife, and we're just gonna cut that extra material out from the print. After cutting away the material, using a deburring tool works awesome as well. Next, we're gonna take the backer piece and we're gonna slide that into the rails of the side piece. Then we'll insert an M3 by 12 screw into the hole here. And we're going to attach one of the rail guides. And the rail guides, you just use a M3 nut, and that slots right into that. And we're going to just tighten this, not fully, but just to where it's holding everything together. Now we're going to put together the left side holder. So we're going to grab the rail to that. And this we want to put in two M3 nuts. And the easiest way to do that is just grab any M3 screws of any length, and we're just going to pull them into position and then just remove the screw. This locks the nut in place. Next, we're going to attach the left side holder to the left side rail using M3 by 8 screws. Now we're going to attach the right side rail to the right side holder. For now, we're going to slide these in place about 1 inch. Take one of the rail guides and we're going to put that right in position like this. And with the hole lined up, we're going to install an M6 screw and we're just going to partially tighten it. And we're going to do this for both of the screw holes. And last, we just want to make sure that the holder is not too far to the right, where when it's slid onto the rails, it will collide with the tabs. You can also add up to 4 10x2 refrigerator magnets. These will hold your trays in place when you slide them all the way back.
Whoa, whoa!
For this project, you're going to need to use the GEN2 large rails. I've included those in the files for this project on printables. For installation instructions, I'll include a link in the description. So each one of these GEN2 rails, I consider one unit. So for this project, we're going to need to use 5. The easiest way to do this is to print a large rail that consists of 4 units and then maybe one additional unit. In this situation, I'm going to be using a 4 wide and a 3 wide because I have a lot of space to cover. In the past, I recommended using a template to position these, but I find it a lot easier to now just use a scratch awl and then just drill the holes out. I didn't want this holder to be the only thing used on these rails, so I went huge and I put this 4 unit wide drawer case on there. And next to that, I just put one large single unit drawer case. Now we'll install the right holder. And we're gonna lock that in place using 2 M3 by 6 screws. and then slide the left side of the holder in place. This is going to be 5 units to the left. And we're going to use 2 M3 6 screws on this as well to lock into position. Now back to the right holder, we can adjust the placement of it to the width of our steel sheet and then tighten these 2 screws to lock it in position. You can then slide the stopper to the depth that you want and lock it in place using this screw. And that's it. You can now store your very large print steel sheets in a safe spot, directly below your printer.
If you enjoy projects such as this, consider joining my club on printables.com. It greatly supports me at creating my next project or creating content like this. Or just follow me on printables.com. I'll give you the latest updates on projects that are coming out. And club members do receive early access to some projects, as well as my CAD files I'm working on. But all in all, I greatly appreciate everyone's support over the years, and we're gonna keep working on this stuff, so stay in touch.
For more on my Gen 2 storage system, download my interactive PDF or check the links below in the description.